to make sure that there's this image that somehow I'm a Trump lackey. I said no to Trump's very first bill. I said no to Trump when the farm bill was passed and won by one vote because it had cuts to SNAP benefits to working poor. I've stood up to him time again and I have no problem doing it. She doesn't want you to know that, but I'm an independent person. That's all there is to it.
Congressman, I've never said that you were a bad guy, nor would I, because this is not personal. And I have made a point of not making this personal, something you have not chosen to do. Everything that I talk to the voters about your 90% voting record with Trump is true. And you tell us that you want to be considered independent from him, and yet you brought the vice president, Mike Pence, to our district. You brought Ivanka Trump to our district. You brought Rick Perry to our district. You brought Linda McMahon to our district. You are literally standing with the Trump administration, in addition to voting with Donald Trump's agenda, which is anything but a moderate agenda. And you have done that more than 90% of the time. And that is information that the voters need, that they understand, and that they don't seem to be particularly happy about.
I have to respond to that because it's important. You know, first of all, I'm one of the most bipartisan members of all of Congress. That is indisputable. Number one, I brought those people up here not for me. I brought them up for my constituents. Ivanka Trump came up here to help high school kids in the inner city with the PTAC program, which is going to help them get to college. And I'm not going to apologize for that. I'm not going to apologize for Vice President Pence going to Nucor Steel and meet with those workers there and to cheer them on and say, this is great. I'm not going to apologize for Linda McMahon coming here as the head of the Small Business Administration to figure out how we can better work with small businesses. And I'm absolutely not going to apologize for Secretary Perry coming up here to help us and promote nuclear energy, which is clean, carbon-free emissions, in which several groups that endorsed her are trying to abolish.
One moment. So,
one final thought.
Mike Pence came here to do a $1,000 a plate fundraiser for you. And when Rick Perry came to visit, the administration acknowledged that that was a campaign event. So again, let's be honest with the voters about what's really happening.
Let's move on to the again, she's trying to pull you away from it. Don't fall for it.